1700. Now, live in studio, local and national real estate expert and consumer advocate, Ron Siegel.
And hello again. Welcome to Ron Siegel Radio. This is the show with no real boundaries as we discuss current events, financial markets, politics, sports, even poking fun at the rest of the media. This is the show that connects the dots of confusion delivered by conflicting media reports. We connect the dots so you know the actions you can take, how your family, your business can benefit from current events. Whew. Most of all, thank you for joining me. Before we get into our intriguing content today, please join me in welcoming, we've got two guests, both of whom are going to be checking in with us throughout the day. We've got Robert Mott, our Wednesday feature, will be checking in a bit later. And then we've got David Meltzer, Sports One Marketing. He will be checking in as well. And let me remind you, if you ever have any home or finance-related questions, I am the consumer advocate looking out for you. And you can reach out to me directly at 800-306-1990, 800-306-1990, or ronsiegelradio.com. Just remember, that's the number you call anytime for assistance. When you call that number, it comes directly to me first. There are no operators standing by. I am it.
Quiet, numbskulls, I'm broadcasting.
While we do have a great team when it comes to developing a financing planner, plan to save you money, I personally work with you. Even if you don't have any needs today, save this number in your phone for future reference, 800-306-1990, 800-306-1990. And boy, do we have celebrations galore today. You gotta love it. Happy birthday to Barbie. I'm going to have to see if our friend David, when he checks in, he's got his Happy Birthday Barbie song going today. But on the other hand, having been the one, how do they do this? National Registered Dietitian Nutritionist Day is on the same day as National Crab Meat Day and National Meatball Day. And I guess the way you get through all of this is you just say, today's National Get Over It Day. So get over it. Got to have a good time here. Get over it. That is the issue. Got a lot going on in the news once again. Can we say a hearty goodbye? I guess that's kind of a pun in and of itself. Saying a hearty goodbye to Carl's Jr. Yeah, they also own the Hardee's chain, but Carl's Jr. saying sayonara to California. They're getting tired of, I guess California could not compete with Nashville, Tennessee. Really? And Carl's is moving their corporate headquarters to Nashville, Tennessee. Company founded 60 years ago in Anaheim and relocating their California headquarters to Nashville. Not an issue of not liking the people of California, because it looks like they're going to offer most all of their staff relocation packages to move to Nashville, Tennessee. I guess that, you know, they say it right on there that a lot of the issues just have to do with the fact California, it's a tough place to do business, and some of these big companies are making that vote or taking that vote. They're casting their vote. Yeah, we're going to cast our votes, the rest of us, in June for the elections, but business gets the opportunity of casting their vote with their wallet and with their feet and their walking. Just a thought that you might want to keep that in mind moving right along. Tax season is scam season. Officials warn of tax scams, ID theft as tax season gets into high gear. Unbelievable how we keep on having to talk about this. If you remember, I think it was last week, Tom Borsick was in, and we were chatting about Tom and his assistance to our seniors. And we were chatting about the idea, while Tom was in the car with some seniors just recently, he actually had three scammers call the senior that was in his car that day. Three people scamming this senior.
So I know who's asked to kick.
Exactly. And basically what they do is they're calling saying that they need money, or they've got a they're calling from the IRS and they owe money and they've got a warrant out for their arrest. Go to Western Union, send the certain amount of money by Western Union. That is a scam. I hate to be the bearer of this issue, but almost any time you hear the two words, Western Union, if you hear those two words, get the radar up. Do a lot of due diligence before you ever send any money by Western Union. It's just an easy method for these scam artists, these con artists, to take your seniors' money. And they do it, I shouldn't say just seniors, because they're after everybody. But it seems like they go after the seniors most. And the reason I bring that up, because I know that most of our listening group is not seniors. But the reason I bring it up is you have loved ones. And who is telling them about these different scams? Who's warning your parents, your grandparents, about these issues? They didn't deal with these issues when they were younger. So I suggest make sure we're going to try and bring them to you whenever we hear about them. This one right now, people stealing tax returns, stealing information out of a mailbox. A lot of the seniors, they don't want to use the online bill pay services from the banks. They like the idea of getting a piece of paper in the mail, and then they want to get that, see that statement. Then they want to send a check back to make their payment of whatever sort that is. Well, you and I, as tech junkies, really understand that once you've seen somebody's check, once you have seen the face of a check, not very difficult to duplicate it. You go over to Staples or Office Depot or Office Max or whatever, they've got the paper there, and you probably already have a printer at home. It's not that difficult. These people, these crooks, they want to do that. Now, if we can convince our parents, our grandparents, that, hey, you know something, do the online bill pay service. It's a lot safer. It's a lot more secure. When they send a check from the online bill pay services, they have direct access through the post office. Then, on the other end, it's going into a lockbox on the other end, so it's not getting into the mailbox of somebody on the streets in most instances. Amazing. When somebody gets a hold of your tax return, you throw your tax return into your mailbox out in the front yard. Somebody goes and they take that out of there. They've got every piece of information to steal your identity. Tell your parents, tell your grandparents. The Federal Trade Commission reported recently California is the top 10 on the FTC's list of states with highest per capita identity theft complaints for 2015. Top 10. Got to let our parents and grandparents know these things. They've got to try and help them out, share that information. Their kids probably are not in jail, so when you get they get that call in the middle of the night, we don't want them going and getting a prepaid debit card from the local market or Target or wherever, Walmart, that has $595 on it. That's the issue that they use most of the time. Think about it. Let's stand up together and talk about these issues so that we can help our seniors. Amazing how this continues to be an issue on a regular basis. Issue for a regular. We may actually start seeing some of the candidates coming to California. Have you been following any of the politics last night? A lot going on. Probably the end of the road for Marco Rubio. Should be. I've favored him. Probably the end of the road for John Kasich. Should be. But we might start seeing some of these politicians coming to California. Just a thought there. I know our primary is not until June, but we might start seeing some of the politicians coming here for something other than just money. Usually when we see the politicians here, they're coming for the dough. Maybe we'll see something a little bit different this year because we may have the votes that are required for Donald Trump to get over his delegate needs. We may have the votes or the required numbers for Hillary Clinton to get into her delegate needs unless she gets indicted by the FBI. We'll see about that one as well. And California, new bill trying to ban Junkets funded by interest groups. What are junkets funded by interest groups? Well, it's basically where the politicians claim they're going on a trip, Hawaii or Cabo or China, Japan, to do research, market research. But they've got special interest groups paying those bills. What do you think that really is? I'll leave that for your decision. But there is a bill going through the state legislature to try and eliminate those junket trips paid for by special interests. You are listening to Ron Siegel Radio, discussing your real estate current events and the financial markets. When we come back, we will be chatting with Robert Mott. I hear there's a new survey about red wine. We're going to talk to Robert and see what his thoughts are on it. David Meltzer is going to be in the house. We're going to talk to him about Maria Sharapova, Facebook, and Thursday night football. All that and more. Remember, you can reach me anytime. Call the off-air number, 800-306-1990, 800-306-1990, or ronsiegelradio.com. Connect with us, facebook.com/ronsiegelradio, and on Twitter, at Ron Siegel. Stay tuned. We'll be back in just a few.
Are you earning a safe, secure 10%+ return on your investments? Is your credit score over 800? Are you living in the home of your dreams or simply where you think you can afford? If the answer to any of these questions is no, what are you doing about it? Text ATP to 79564. Complete a 3-minute complimentary survey and the area trusted professionals of Ron Siegel Radio will reach out to you to develop a success strategy for you. Again, all you need to do is text ATP to 79564.
Ron Siegel Radio Date Night Trivia, presented by Reunion Kitchen and Drink. Friday, Ron will pose a question based on on-air conversations during the prior 7 programs. The person to post the answer according to the guest conversation will win a date night package, including a dinner gift card for Reunion Kitchen and Drink. You might even be able to say hi to Ron when you visit Reunion Kitchen and Drink.
It's not every day your home gets flooded, but when it happens, you've got the good people at APRIS on your side. With over 25 years of construction and insurance experience, they can turn any disaster around, making your home good as new. For 24/7 support, call 844-GO-APRIS or find us on the web at www.apris.me. Day, night, rain, or shine, when it happens to you, you know what to do. Go APRIS. Remember, call 844-GO-APRIS. That's 844-462-7747.
Are you a veteran, own a home, and need money? The Siegel Lending Team is here to help veterans refinance and get the money they need. The VA 100 lets you borrow up to 100% of your home's value, refinance your mortgages, consolidate credit cards, and lower your payments by an average of $700 a month. And the Siegel Lending Team knows that character means more than a credit score. Call 800-306-1990. That's 800-306-1990. Rate subject to change without notice. Licensed by the California Department of Corporations, NMLS 21037, and DRE number 01869452.
You're listening to Ron Siegel's Home and Finance Show with local and national expert Ron Siegel. Now, here's Ron.
Welcome back to Ron Siegel Radio. Within every market, there are solutions as well as tremendous opportunities. You just need some trusted guidance. That's my message, and as your consumer advocate, I will be delivering it every day on Ron Siegel Radio or anytime at 800-306-1990, 800-306-1990. The Your Credit Matters segment today brought to you by CreditSanitizer.com. You have a credit report. It is wrong. The question is, what are you doing about it? Credit Sanitizer does have the solution for you. You just need to check them out, creditsanitizer.com. Got this interesting question, and I couldn't resist but sharing it today in the Your Credit Matters segment. And I had somebody reach out, and they said that they planned a bachelorette party, and they follow our guidance on a regular basis. They continually watch their credit scores. And after the planning of a bachelorette party, they found that their credit score had dropped by 24 points. How can that happen was the question. Well, it is kind of ironic, it is kind of funny, but basically what has happened in the situation that was shared with me is all the deposits that go in for bachelorette, bachelor party events of any sort, Those deposits go on your credit card. That's credit card utilization. We've talked about that before. And if those deposits hit there in just the right time, right before your statement closing date, you may end up having a different utilization number on your credit card balances. Remember, I've told you before, pay those balances right before the statement closing date. Ignore the due date. It's right before the statement closing date gets you the best numbers for your credit scores. And that's what happened here. That is the Your Credit Matters segment brought to you by creditsanitizer.com. Red wine means it is time for our Wednesday chat with Robert Mott. Good morning, Robert.
Good morning, Ron. How are you today?
I am doing wonderful. And once I saw this story, I forgot what day I saw this, but I've been doing better and better. And I wanted to share this with you and just get your take on it. It might be it's a little bit different than what you and I generally talk about, because this one has a little bit to do with exercise. And I saw a report recently that says drinking a glass of red wine is as healthy as an hour at the gym. What do you think?
Well, I think I saw that article somewhere, to tell you the truth. I was somewhat intrigued by it. I didn't actually read it in detail to see what their rationale was.
It has to do with the, what do they call it, resveratrol?
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. So those antioxidant compounds that are prevalent in all wines, but they're especially prevalent in red wines, those that have the color and the depth of color with them. But yeah, there's some antioxidant characteristics associated with red wine, and of course that is supposed to work against those things like, you know, kind of a premature aging and cancer and the like.
Well, I bet you're going to have the same thought that I do, Robert. I'm going to go out on a limb here because you and I have chatted many, many times. If drinking one glass is like 1 hour at the gym, then two glasses has to be better.
Yeah, and a whole bottle, that's like almost like a week at the gym almost, I think.
There you go. Well, I'll just read one little bit of it, and then we'll get into the conversation that we had for us. Is that it basically says that the chemical resveratrol, naturally found in red wine, has numerous health and heart positive benefits, including improved physical performance. I don't know what they mean by that. Heart function and muscle strength. Red wine could actually enhance the cardiovascular benefits of exercise.
Yeah, I agree. Red wine is certainly a great beverage to include in your daily routine, obviously. But on the other hand, I don't think I would totally discount the value of exercise in addition to a little bit of red wine as well. So, obviously, want people living to the ripe old age of wine drinking, like our late great good friend Robert Mondavi did, and obviously red wine did a lot for him, but I think he was a very trim, fit man all the way into his late 90s. So I think it's probably a balance like everything else in life.
Well, it's those 6 ounce curls that do wonders for people.
Exactly. I have to change up hands, so my left bicep is the same size as my right bicep on that, you know.
And mine just dangles, but I've beaten anorexia. But we better get on to the conversation here. What's the differentiates reserve designation from a standard vineyard designation?
Well, you know, it's a great question, and it's one that I think it confuses a lot of consumers.
I know I'm confused by it.
I'm sorry?
I am definitely confused by it. I thought it's just price.
Yeah, you know, and many times you're right. It has a lot to be. There's certainly a correlation between the words reserve on a bottle and the price of the bottle. You get the impression, of course, when it says reserve, especially if it's domestic wine, that the winemaker, you know, cared for it a little bit more than the other wines that they put out, or he held back some special barrels or something like that to make it better. In actuality, in legal terms, it actually means absolutely zero, zilch. you know, the TTB, the people that regulate the stuff that goes on wine and liquor labels, they don't have any meaning. There's no legal meaning for the word reserve. So it really is a marketing term, and in terms of domestic wines anyway. Many times you'll see that reserve wines really are a little bit better, or they are from the best parts of the vineyard or from the best barrels of that particular vintage. But as there's no requirement that they are. In other words, you could take just your regular run-of-the-mill wine and put reserve on. Now, some countries, such as Italy, Spain, Portugal, for instance, have legal definitions of the term reserva or reserva, spelled a little differently. One was spelled with an E, one spelled with an I. And it generally means the wine's been aged for a specified period of time before release. But again, like I said before, in the New World, in Australia, in the United States, and South America, reserve really has, you know, really no meaning whatsoever officially. Now, in reality, there probably is some difference, but officially, I think it's one of those things that, as a consumer, you owe it to yourself to educate yourself about that particular label before you go off and pull the more expensive reserve wine, thinking it may be a lot better.
So we don't want to be fooled by thinking that when we see Charles Shaw Reserve, that doesn't mean it's going to compete with our nice bottle of Hewitt.
Exactly. You know, it may be better than the regular $2 or $3 chuck as it is today. but not much.
But not much. Probably still not something we even want to be cooking with.
I'm always a big believer, and I've told you this before, Ron, never cook with wine that you would not drink. And I know some people make that assumption, oh, well, it's been sitting on my counter for a month, and there's no way I'm going to drink it now because it's vinegar, but I'll cook with it. Well, guess what? Now you're just cooking with kind of really poor vinegar instead of good wine. So, sorry, I get off on a tangent there, but definitely don't cook with anything you're not willing to eat.
Exactly. And you know something? I used to do a lot of cooking, watch some cooking shows with my son, and we used to watch Emeril Lagasse quite a bit, and that was one of his things was, if you're not willing to drink it, don't cook with it, because when you finish that little bit that you need to cook with, what are you going to do with the rest of the bottle?
Exactly, and I'm sure you're a contemporary of mine. You remember the days of Graham Kerr, the Galloping Gourmet. Of course, he had a bit of an alcohol problem, but you know it was always two glasses for him and one glass for the dish that he was making at the time, if I recall.
Makes sense to me. So tell me one other thing before we have to let you run here is, what are the wines? I mean, I see these things, Burgundy. What varietals come from Burgundy?
Yeah, that's a great question as well. Burgundy, of course, Burgundy is a region of France, Burgundy, France. Notable for many reasons. Of course, it's a wine-producing region. Historically, archaeological evidence establishes that viticulture in Burgundy as early as the 2nd century A.D., although it may have been going on before that, when the Celts were growing vines in the region before the Roman conquest of Gaul in the 51 BC. So it's been going on there for a long time. The most famous wines produced there, and the ones commonly referred to as Burgundies, there's a red Burgundy and there's a white Burgundy. So the red Burgundies are essentially Pinot Noir. I know they don't call it that because it's the way the French name their wines. And the white wines are primarily from Chardonnay grapes. So pretty much all Burgundy wines have, you'll note that all Burgundy wines generally come in a bottle with a very sloped shoulder, gently sloped shoulder, not like a Cabernet bottle that has the big wide shoulders at the top. So you'll notice you can look down the shelf and you see the Burgundy varietals generally come with that kind of sloped shoulder bottle as well.
Interesting.
Yeah. In addition, there are some other varietals that come from the region as well. For instance, in the sub-region called Chablis, it's also Chardonnay, but it just has a little different style. And then there's another region called Beaujolais, as you've probably heard of Beaujolais.
Sure.
The primary grape varietal there is Gamay. And so you generally see Gamay Beaujolais or Nouveau Beaujolais coming from that region of France as well. The other thing that you may hear as well, if you're in reference to domestic wines, especially Chardonnay or Pinot Noir, when people are referring to the style, particularly style of Chardonnay, you may say, well, that's a California style Chardonnay. In other words, it's big and buttery and oaky, etc. Or it's a very Burgundian style of Chardonnay, which would tell you that the wine is probably leaner, doesn't have much oak on it, probably didn't go through any malolactic fermentation, so it probably has a higher acid expression of Chardonnay. And likewise, you'll see that Pinot Noir is referenced that way as well, that may be more Burgundian than perhaps a domestic Pinot Noir. So it can be referenced as a stylistic aspect of wine as well.
Interesting. Great information, as always, from Robert Mott. Thank you for joining us every Wednesday. You are listening to Ron Siegel Radio, discussing your real estate, current events, and the financial markets. When we come back, really, would you think about watching Thursday night football on Facebook? I wouldn't even think about that, but it may be happening. The housing market set to spring forward. I wonder if that has anything to do with the time change this weekend. And we'll get some mortgage refinancing tips. All that and more. You can reach us anytime. Call the off-air number, 800-306-1990, 800-306-1990, or ronsiegelradio.com. Connect with us, facebook.com/ronsiegelradio. And if you miss any part of our broadcast, nearly 250,000 people are checking us out on the replays, youtube.com/ronsiegel1. That's the numeral one, youtube.com/ronsiegel1, or RonSiegelRadio.com in the archive. Stay tuned. We'll be back in just a few.
Is your credit score over 800? Are you living in the home of your dreams or simply where you think you can afford? Are you earning a safe, secure 10-plus percent return on your investments? If the answer to any of these questions is no, what are you doing about it? Text ATP to 79564. Complete a 3-minute complimentary survey, and the area trusted professionals of Ron Siegel Radio will reach out to you to develop a success strategy for you. Again, all you need to do is text ATP to 79564.
Are you purchasing or own a luxury home? If you're like so many others, your home is your largest asset and the mortgage is your largest debt. The Siegel Lending Team has some amazing financing opportunities right now. Jumbo loans up to $2 million, 30-year rates below 4%, 15-year rates near 3.5%, and if you can believe it, 7-year interest-only hybrids in low threes. The Siegel Lending Team has all the options for your jumbo or second home loan requirements. Take advantage of them while you can. To learn more about all the other financing products available from the Siegel Lending Team, call 1-800-306-1990. That's 1-800-306-1990. Or visit SiegelLendingTeam.com. That's S-I-E-G-E-L LendingTeam.com. Again, call 1-800-306-1990. Rates subject to change without notice. Licensed by NMLS ID 217037 and 145502. Equal housing lender.
Southern California attorneys have over 15,000 real estate agents to call in Orange County for their personal and professional needs. Why do they overwhelmingly call Melinda Johnson? Simple. It's the Melinda Johnson trifecta. Melinda is an attorney, real estate broker, and realtor. Does your family deserve the same professional services California lawyers demand? Call Melinda Johnson at 714-863-5485. That's 714-863-5485. Or on the web at freedomfirstproperties.com.
Are you a veteran, own a home, and need money? The Siegel Lending Team is here to help veterans refinance and get the money they need. The VA 100 lets you borrow up to 100% of your home's value, refinance your mortgages, consolidate credit cards, and lower your payments by an average of $700 a month. And the Siegel Lending Team knows that character means more than a credit score. Call 800-306-1990. That's 800-306-1990. Rate subject to change without notice. Licensed by the California Department of Corporations, NMLS 21037 and DRE number 01869452.
37% of American homeowners believe they have over 20% equity in their homes. Fannie Mae tells us 69% of American homeowners have over 20% equity in their homes. Fully 1 in 3 American homeowners are not informed about the amount of equity they have in their homes. Are you one of them? How might this be holding you back from achieving your goals? Text RSR CMA to 79564 to get a property valuation from one of the area trusted professionals of Ron Siegel Radio. Again, to know how much your home is really worth, simply text RSR CMA to 79564.
You're listening to Ron Siegel's Home and Finance Show with local and national expert Ron Siegel. Now, here's Ron.
Welcome back to Ron Siegel Radio. Within every market, there are solutions as well as tremendous opportunities. You just need some trusted guidance. That's my message. And as your consumer advocate, I will be delivering it every day on Ron Siegel Radio. or anytime at 800-306-1990, 800-306-1990. I guess we should start chatting. This is the Real Time Real Estate segment, again brought to you by the area trusted professionals of Ron Siegel Radio. Text PAIR, P-E-A-R, Professional Equity Analysis Review, to 79564. Get the true amount of the equity in your property. You can't get it from those online solutions. This will bring you directly to an individual who will chat with you, an area trusted real estate professional that I have vetted in your neighborhood. I haven't started chatting about this at all because I don't know whether we want to even think about it. You know, we're going to have to change the clocks. I think it's this weekend they change again. Housing market, though, is it set to spring forward this year? Yeah, I think you better be looking at that. The National Association of Realtors recently reported that the top 10 dates sellers listed their home in 2015 all fell in April, May, or June. So I've been telling you for the last 3 months, if you're thinking about selling, do it before the competition comes. Well, we are just about at competition. If you're thinking about selling your home, two things I'm going to share with you. Number one, and both of them are free, my favorite word. Number one, get the true amount of equity you have in your property. Text PEAR, P-E-A-R, Professional Equity Analysis Review, to 79564. And then we just came out with our free home buyer's guide. We do it every quarter. The spring home buyer's guide has been, or home seller's guide has been released. Text HSG, home seller's guide. I'm a simple guy. I can't remember too much. So if you can text HSG to 79564, the team will get you that free guide. That is the real-time real estate segment today. So love it. Love the opportunity because, you know, I am a bona fide sports junkie. I love it. So when I get the opportunity to chat with David Meltzer and he comes in studio, David's probably more of a sports junkie than I am. Welcome.
Hey, great to be here. Thanks for having me, Ron.
Glad to have you with us. Love the idea of being able to chat. I have folks ask me all the time. In fact, I was, while my wife was at this event that you were at last night, the women International Women's Event, I actually happened to be over at Reunion, sitting at the bar, having a drink by myself, chatting with people in the bar. And they said, well, you do a business show on a sports network. How does that work? And I said, well, we talk about sports and business. So I thought that one of the items I wanted to chat with you about, Thursday Night Football on Facebook.
Yeah.
What's that about? Have you been following a lot of that?
Absolutely. You know, it started last year when the NFL partnered with Yahoo, and they did the streaming deal for $20 million. They had 2.36 million viewers in October in that experience, and an experiment. And so now they have everybody bidding for the streaming rights for Thursday Night Football.
Wow.
And Facebook seems to be in the lead.
And they're talking about some serious, what was it? Hundreds of millions of dollars, I think, is what I heard.
Yeah, they're looking at a really big deal. The TV deal was $450 million by CBS and NBC that they signed last year. Now they have, you know, some pretty big companies. So you have Facebook, Amazon, and Verizon. So there's nobody short of cash in that list.
Exactly.
And the content seems to be renewable and expandable. So everyone's looking to see if Thursday Night Football's, which, you know, is the best place to stream, right? Because we have so much ubiquity in the Sunday games,
right?
That the Thursday night games, guys are at work, on the road, you know, streaming is much more prevalent than on the weekend when you want to sit there, you know, with your pizza and the six pack with your huge TV.
And you know something, I'm glad you brought that up because I'm not one of the biggest fans in the world of Thursday Night Football. Heck, more often than not, maybe it's just because I'm old and I am a creature of habit, I almost always forget about it.
Yeah.
I mean, I would assume that their audience is significantly smaller on Thursday night.
It is, especially if it's not a big game.
Yeah, so, it's not your team.
Right, you have these promotions that go, and you know, there's some leading teams, obviously, that play. And when they do play, we get some great Thursday Night Football following. But a lot of people, and I'm, you know, going to date myself, but you and I are close to the same age. I find myself, and I'm a football guy. I'm not just a sports guy. I love football. Played it in college. My partner is the Hall of Fame quarterback, Warren Moon. I represent, you know, players in the Hall of Fame. I am football,
sure.
And I do the same thing. All of a sudden, you know, at 7:30, I tell my wife, oh, shoot, the game's on.
Right.
But there are times that I want to see the game that all I have is my computer with me because I do travel, I do speak around the world.
Sure.
And this streaming deal is going to be of interest to me.
I think it's going to be a lot of fun, but I wonder what's going to end up happening, because I mean, I know you represent a lot of the sponsors as well. Is I wonder what's going to happen with sponsors, because they've always had that monopoly where we had to go and watch on TV. And now if I can go to Facebook, I don't have to go see the some of the sponsors there. I wonder if it's going to ever cannibalize itself.
They'll find ways to... We have content, access, and mediums. And they're going to find a way to provide their content, whatever way we access it, on whatever mediums we provide. So whether it's framing, 3D technology, inlays, product placement, signage, voiceovers, they are going to figure out a way to get the message across. And of course, we have the interactive side with polling and betting and all of these other areas where eventually all TV is basically streamed anyway.
Sure.
And so that ubiquity of being able to access it and to poll it and to bet on it and real time is going to create all types of interaction for not only the game but the sponsors as well.
Absolutely. I want to transition a little bit and get your thoughts, because you and I have chatted about, especially when it comes to football, about the performance enhancing drugs and some of the things that go on with kids. And I think probably especially right now, this week, this time, one of the biggest stories is Maria Sharapova.
Yeah.
And you know, I've got a lot of mixed emotions about this, David. I look at it and say there's got to be the you have to keep things fair based on the rules of the game. But I also wonder, when does the rules of the game, where does that stop and an individual's health take over? And I looked at this report, and she's being, you know, she was. Tested positive for the drug, but she's been taking this drug for 10 years for health purposes.
Right. It's meldonium. It's right. A heart medicine that she's been taking. It was just banned as of January 1st, 2016.
Right.
So the problem with rules is that, especially when we're dealing with leagues, teams, and organizations, is there's really no exceptions.
Okay.
And so where you have a banned drug that you're on, there should be an ability to prove medical use.
Right.
Well, the league doesn't want to get into that, because now you have to create these boards to evaluate, you know, whether marijuana is for medical purposes or is
sure.
it. And so I come from a different school, and, you know, it may not be a popular one, but I believe there should be a no ban list for any athletes. I think what's happening is you nobody ever heard of meldonium before,
right.
But now kids are going to start using it. They literally will start using it now. And so it has the exact reverse effect because of the energy that you put. What you resist persists. So what they should do is allow professional athletes to use whatever they want, but they need to have an education list that goes down every drug. And whether the performance enhancing, because that's the only way, especially with technologies today and the synthetic drugs, that's the only way we're going to have fair competition, is you literally, if they're willing to take the chance with their own, look, you could argue any sport is detrimental to your health.
Sure. Yeah. I mean, you probably know, I'm sure you know the statistics better than me, but I think I read somewhere that the average life expectancy of an NFL football player is like 58 years old.
58 years old.
So they know they're trading 30 years of their life on averages. I mean, we don't know specifics.
Well, there's a component in there just for education to everyone, that football players are on average bigger than most
okay.
people.
Right.
And that bigger people, thank goodness for me, don't live as long. The heart.
I don't know if I like that.
I know. The truth is, you're dead when your heart stops beating, and
sure.
your heart, if it has to handle a 400-pound body, it's not going to last as long. And then that's medically proven. So there is some of that in there, but there's no doubt that the strain and stress on the physical body from playing professional football, because most of these guys play from 10 until 30 or 35, can do some serious detriment to your health.
You know, something that's a good point, because when you think about the concept of any of the professional athletes, they're not getting paid because they're a great football player. They're getting paid because of the entertainment value and the people that are following them. And you see something like this drug, and I think you're exactly onto something that no one's talking about. You're the first person I've ever heard say that.
Yeah.
That, you know, it has the exact opposite effect, because you're right, the kids do follow them. Good, bad, or indifferent, they follow.
And there's no testing in high school. In most of the colleges, there's hardly any testing. So if you have a kid that may be on the border of getting a college scholarship, and he sees now that there's this heart drug that he can use to enhance his, and it's $250,000 or $500,000. I saw USC, our favorite school there, is $50-some thousand tuition a year. You know, and I might consider this lady's been on it for 10 years. Nothing really bad has happened to her.
Right.
Except for she's a great tennis player.
Yeah.
You know, and I'm trying to get a tennis scholarship to USC. You know, no one's going to test me.
Right.
Once I'm in, I got my scholarship. I can make that decision. But furthermore, no one's testing in the NCAA for that drug either.
So now we're going to get a run on that. And
it's arbitrary.
And with her thing, she went to a doctor and got it. You know, we know that the kids at USC or some of these other schools, they're going to go and try and get it off the street.
Online, or right. In Mexico. This is where they get their drugs.
Not going to be nearly as safe. We're going to talk more about that. We also want to talk a couple of big events David's or programs David's got going on. Processing for a Cause, the Unstoppable Gala, mission meetings, all that coming up. We'll also talk... We got a lot to cover, and we don't have a whole lot of time, so I better get out of here. You're listening to Ron Siegel Radio, discussing your real estate current events and the financial markets. You can reach us anytime. Call the off-air number, 800-306-1990, 800-306-1990, or ronsiegelradio.com. Connect with us, facebook.com/Ron Siegel Radio, on Twitter, @Ron Siegel, and don't forget... The broadcasts get put onto YouTube. It's youtube.com/Ron Siegel 1. 250,000 of you checking those out. Stay tuned. We'll be back in just a few.
In the middle of a street.
Are you living in the home of your dreams or simply where you think you can afford? Are you earning a safe, secure 10%+ return on your investments? Is your credit score over 800? If the answer to any of these questions is no, what are you doing about it? Text ATP to 79564. Complete a 3-minute complimentary survey, and the area trusted professionals of Ron Siegel Radio will reach out to you to develop a success strategy for you. Again, all you need to do is text ATP to 79564.
Do you have a loved one who wants to stay in their home, but you have health concerns about it? The Preferred Care Team understands the challenges of caring for your loved ones. Their goal is to keep seniors as independent as possible while maintaining their health, safety, and overall well-being. Whether you need just a few hours a week or 24-hour care, Preferred Care caregivers are trained to meet your needs. Call Preferred Care at 714-696-9150. That's 714-696-9150. Or visit preferredcare.com.
In these uncertain times, it's getting harder and harder to find a safe and effective method of investing. If you're looking at retirement options that can provide some real security for you and your family, look no further than a reverse mortgage with Siegel Lending Team. Hundreds of thousands of other Americans are already taking advantage of reverse mortgages. It allows you to eliminate monthly mortgage payments, pay some bills, or simply enjoy your retirement more. A government-insured reverse mortgage with Siegel Lending Team allows seniors to stay in their home and turn their equity into tax-free cash. To qualify, there are no credit score requirements, and remember, you continue to retain complete ownership of your home. Call 1-800-306-1990 to receive a new special edition handbook, feature reverse mortgage borrowers, plus an educational brochure absolutely free. Find out more. Call Siegel Lending Team today, 1-800-306-1990. SiegelLendingTeam.com. That's S-I-E-G-E-L LendingTeam.com or 1-800-306-1990.
Are you currently renting a home? Do you like paying someone else's mortgage payment? Why not explore the options to purchase your own home? Can you imagine a 30-year fixed-rate loan below 4.25% APR? This means with $10,500, you can purchase a $295,000 home and have a principal and interest payment of about $1,400 per month. What are you paying in rent? Does your family deserve the opportunity to take advantage of the current market? To learn more about these exciting opportunities, the Siegel Lending Team is standing by to speak with you. Call now, 1-800-306-1990. That's 1-800-306-1990. Or visit SiegelLendingTeam.com. That's S-I-E-G-E-L LendingTeam.com. Or 1-800-306-1990. Rates subject to change without notice. Licensed by NMLS ID 217037 and 145502. Equal housing lender. Not endorsed or sponsored by any government agency.
The SDCCU biggest used car sale is this Saturday, Del Mar Fairgrounds. Special financing as low as 0.75% APR. Subject to approval, visit at sdccu.com.
You're
listening to Ron Siegel's Home and Finance Show with local and national expert Ron Siegel. Now, here's Ron.
Within every market, there are solutions as well as tremendous opportunities. You just need some trusted guidance. That's my message, and as your consumer advocate, I will be delivering it every day on Ron Siegel Radio or anytime at 800-306-1990, 800-306-1990. See what happens when you leave the host one button to turn? Got this confusion here. All on the host, serious problems. You got to watch out for that guy. The Mortgage Minute today being brought to you by our friends at VIP Mortgage. When you have that mortgage, when you're ready for it, one day out of short sale, one day out of bankruptcy, one day out of foreclosure, as well as the basic things, VIP Mortgage has those products for you. Here's the question that we want to talk about real brief today because I want to get back to chatting with David. What is truly a reverse mortgage? What is it? And it also goes by the official name, HECM. Home Equity Conversion Mortgage. Nothing more than a lien on a piece of property, just like your existing forward mortgage. One is a forward mortgage, one is a reverse mortgage. Either way, they're a lien. You own the property. You never give up title on the property as long as you're in good standing. How do you stay in good standing? Well, pay your property taxes. You got to do that either way. Pay your insurance. Got to do that either way. Pay the homeowners and keep the property maintained. Now, the big difference on the forward mortgage, you're basically making a payment, money coming out of your pocket to pay the interest monthly and bring down the principal balance. On a reverse mortgage, it's very, very simple. It's just the opposite. You do not make a payment, and the interest is simply added to the amount of the lien. That's all there is to it. You own it, you control it, you can sell it, you can refinance it, you can give it away, you can do anything you want to as long as you, as a senior, are living in the property and you pay the taxes and you pay the insurance, maintain it. That's it. That's the Mortgage Minute brought to you by our friends at VIP Mortgage. So we're continuing our conversation this morning. David Meltzer, Sports One Marketing, our business of sports guru in the house today, always chatting about something new and different. You got a new venture, processing for a cause. What's that all about?
You know, we work so hard. We started a program years ago, Commerce for a Cause.
Right.
And we learned the interesting aspects of processing.
Which we should back up a little bit, David, because a lot of people that don't know your story and they haven't read one of the best books in the world, Connected to Goodness, it's David's book. But way back when you were partners with Lee Steinberg, you started the idea or promoted the idea that athletes had to donate a percentage of their money to nonprofit organizations in the communities.
Correct.
And you're still doing that, man. Now tell us about this new venture with processing.
Yeah, in fact, let me take it a step farther because you know my favorite saying and for business is make a lot of money, help a lot of people, and have a lot of fun.
And we close every show with it.
It's a great way to close your show. And we found that this industry of processing was going to change with these new chips. But they came to us and they asked us to get athletes to promote it. And so instead, we shifted the paradigm and said, instead of paying athletes, why don't you pay the people who are charging the cards, the merchants, and give them a percentage to go to whatever cause they want, their kids' soccer team, their schools, or big charities like Boys and Girls Club or St. Jude. And we created the first program. We had the wrong name on it. We've really built it up now. It's Processing for a Cause, processingforacause.com. Three easy steps. Not only can you go on there and seamlessly, whatever time you swipe your cards for your customers, a portion of those bank fees will go to the charity of your choice. But if you're a charity, you can use this as a program to get all of the people who normally write you checks, never to write you a check again, but instead to give you more money to you from those bank fees instead of the First Data, the biggest processor in the world, who's generously worked this deal with us to go directly with them, which they normally don't do. They normally use these ISO, go directly to First Data, and that savings there goes right to your charity of choice.
I love it because, you know, the idea here is you're not doing anything different.
Right.
Right? I mean, if you own a car dealership or you own the local bakery or the pizza shop, right, it doesn't matter what it is, you're paying a credit card processing fee.
Yep.
And
Do you 100% want to, tax deductible.
Yeah, I mean, you're giving that money away, but now you can direct it right back to the community.
Yeah, of your choice.
Right.
Literally, of your choice. So it can go to the smallest program to the largest foundations that we have.
I love it. If you want to get involved, again, processingforacause.com. Just go right to the website there. I looked at it this morning. I mean, you can just put a little... It'll take you 2 seconds to fill out the survey there. Make sure you put in there, Ron Siegel, that you heard it there. That way, David knows that people were listening to him this morning. We want to make sure that they know we're there, right? I mean, I make him get up and come over here early in the morning. We're probably going to catch a plane or somewhere on the way after he leaves here. But, okay, and then I see that we've got an unstoppable gala.
Well, yeah.
What is an unstoppable gala?
Yeah, I'm on the board of the Unstoppable Foundation, and you know, all these guys like Peyton Manning. I know this is a sports segment.
Right.
You know, we give these guys so much heartache, and here most of these guys are human, so they've made mistakes somewhere since they were 18 till they're 38 years old. I guarantee you, every one of us have made those mistakes.
I don't even want to think about some of those.
I think there should be a rule that once you're over 35, nothing you did before 21 should ever be brought up.
That makes sense to me. I love it. If we go to 22, that was about when I graduated college.
Exactly, yeah, exactly. Somewhere there. But, you know, guys like Peyton Manning, you know, he has his own Payback Foundation, PEY Foundation. I have the Unstoppable Foundation. You know, we want to eradicate all poverty in the world through education. Really simple idea. We build villages around the world and we teach people how to empower other people. So we don't just come in and bring you water. We teach you how to create clean water for yourself. We build schools, hundreds of schools the Unstoppable Foundation has built around the world. We have our first, you know, in some of these countries, women don't get to go to school. We have our first graduating class. Last year, we had our first woman go to college.
Wow,
It's an amazing, so at the LA Live Marriott, you go to unstoppable.com, and it's a 660-person sold-out every year event. People, you know, like Warren Moon, Lee Steinberg, Marcellus Wiley, Diane Cannon, and then they have all the really famous authors there, too, which I really dig. So you got Canfield and Proctor, you know, all these famous guys, the Think and Grow Rich crowd.
Wow.
They're all there as well. So, you know, come out, have a great time, unbelievable entertainment and food, great celebrity watching and sports watching, but most of all, you know, we're going to eradicate poverty through education, something some of these politicians should probably consider.
Absolutely. And we should, embarrass you a little bit.
Oh, no.
Because, and I didn't even put this on the notes, so Bradley, if he's listening, he's going to really get me now. Because I had a conversation with somebody that Bradley introduced me to, I think it was last week or the week before, and we were talking about you, and we said, how is it that a sports agent can win an award for being a humanitarian? So congratulations, buddy.
Thank you. Yeah, Bradley's my PR agent. So Variety Magazine named me Sports Humanitarian of the Year last week. Pre-Oscar award with Matthew McConaughey, Morgan Freeman, Olivia Wilde, Gina Rodriguez, you know, Seth Rogen. So I couldn't be the most talented, smartest, best looking, or funniest. There was no room for me anywhere. So I think that's why they decided, hey, let's just put a sports agent, because we have all the other skill sets here, so let's lower the bar for everyone. And I made a joke when I was there, and I said, I guess to be the sports humanitarian of the year, that means that I wasn't convicted in 2015 of something.
No, you know something, getting to know you over the last few years, it's been fun because I watch all the things that you're doing and people that you're out there helping and the communities. I mean, the people that you've introduced us to bring on radio because of your associations with them. So I think it's very, very well deserved, and I think it's a great tribute to what you're doing and the mission that you have. I mean, it's not just out there trying to make money and things. I mean, which obviously is great, and I love your motto because you live it every day. It's not just a line in the book.
Yeah, no, I truly believe. Sometimes people ask me, why does it say make a lot of money? And you and I are both businessmen, because I've been rich twice in my life, and once I learned I can only give what I have, and I'm so much more powerful when I make a lot of money, because 90% of all things that we need and want can be bought, including better health, better education, all of these things that we want. The 10% that can't is the truth, and so I spent 90% of my time trying to deal with the truth of myself that personal growth side. But the 10% of my focus is on making sure that I make a lot of money. And what happens is, if you focus on the 90% of time on the truth, the 10% just comes so easily. When you're a truthful, good person, everything comes to you with no resistance.
That's you know something, and I love it. That's why I've told so many people, I've given away so many of your books, is because of that. And every single person, I'm gonna plug it again. We didn't even plan on plugging the book, Connected to Goodness. Go on Amazon, go wherever you buy books. One of the best books I've ever read, because it tells you that story, making money, making some errors. You know, yeah. And obviously the most important part, and I'll throw another plug in there, shameless, is, you know, it's the women behind us that, you know, losing everything but the one most important thing.
Yeah, no doubt. And so, I get choked up thinking about it. So that's why I did the International Women's Day. I stood up with, you know, as an only male, you know, to start and say.
I was wondering, I heard you were there, and I'm going, okay, how's David get invited to International Women's Day? And he's a humanitarian.
We're going to talk. Sports agent.
Sports, we're going to talk about that more. Be sure to set that first radio preset button to come back here every day to join Ron Siegel Radio, where we only speak about items affecting your house and your bank account. Thanks to all of our sponsors, and again, thanks to our guests. That's all for Ron Siegel Radio. Again, if you have any questions or to meet any of our guests, just give me a call at 800-306-1990, 800-306-1990. And remember, make a lot of money, help a lot of people, have a lot of fun. Have a great day. We'll talk to you next time on Ron Siegel Radio.
You're listening to ESPN Radio 1700.